Now we will consider bar magnet as an equivalent solenoid. So we know what is a bar magnet, and previously we have seen the magnetic field lines for a bar magnet and solenoid are same. So this time we will take a solenoid and show that the magnetic field produced by this solenoid is very similar to one that is produced by the bar magnet. So this is the equivalence. So here we can see a solenoid. This is a solenoid. So we have already seen that Ampere hypothesis. There was an Ampere's hypothesis that all magnetic phenomena can be explained in terms of circulating currents. So that we have already seen. So in this solenoid, a current is also circulating in circular loops. So magnetism can be explained by current circulating in the circular loops or current circulating in the loops. Now remember one quantity, which is dipole moment. Dipole moment or magnetic moment. Magnetic moment, what was the magnetic moment? Simply current into area, and if there are n number of turns, this is multiplied by the number of turns. So this is current into area, that means ampere meter square. If there are n number of turns, this is multiplied by n, where n is the number of turns in the loop, I is the current, and A is the area vector. Again, this is, if you see, this is a vector quantity, this is also a vector quantity. I and n both are scalar quantities. Now we have to see the similarities in bar magnet and this solenoid. So a bar magnet may be thought as a large number of circulating currents. So suppose if we take a bar magnet, we can also think bar magnet that there are a large number of currents are circulating. A large number of currents are circulating in this bar magnet. So this makes a very similar to a similar entity, similar to solenoid. So circulating currents in analogy with a solenoid. So similarly, in a solenoid, large number of currents are circulating. So in this way, this is the first way in which we see that solenoid and bar magnets are equal. Second thing, we saw the pattern of magnetic field lines were similar. Also, cutting a bar magnet in half, suppose if we cut this bar magnet into half, so what will happen? The magnetic field lines or the magnetism of the bar would be weakened. So we get two smaller solenoids. Suppose if we cut this bar magnet into two small pieces, so we will get two magnets with less magnetic field, less magnetism. So suppose if this magnetism is 250 gauss, then magnetic field of these two smaller magnets would be weaker than 250 gauss. Similarly, if we cut this solenoid into two pieces, we get two smaller solenoids with weaker magnetic properties. So the magnetic field will be weak in this case as well. So this is the third similarity. Suppose if this is the solenoid, if we put a compass needle just near to it, so a compass needle in neighborhood of a bar magnet and a current carrying finite solenoid, there would be some deflection. Suppose this was the direction, so it will be deflected. So if we put a magnet here, then it will deflect. In presence of a solenoid, it will also deflect. So again, these are similarities. A small compass needle in the neighborhood of a bar magnet and a current carrying solenoid. So this is solenoid and this is a needle. Or if we put a bar magnet, so in both the cases, the deflections on needle are similar. So needle will deflect. So in all these ways, we have understood that a solenoid is equivalent to a bar magnet. So now let us see what we have in the diagram. So let this needle behind. So what we have to see now, we have this solenoid. Now this solenoid is shown as a cylinder, thin sheet cylinder. सिलेंडर मेड ऑफ थिन शीट. वॉट आर अदर फीचर्स ऑफ दिस सिलेंडर? सो इफ यू सी दिस ओ इज द सेंटर ऑफ द सिलेंडर. दिस ओ इज द सेंटर ऑफ द सिलेंडर. लेंथ इज 2L. टोटल लेंथ इज 2L. L length on one side, L length on the other side of this center point. This O is the center point. L length one side, L length another side. What is the radius? Radius is A. Radius of this cylinder is A. Now we need magnetic field at this point P, which is at a distance R. Which is at a distance R. So this is our figure. See it once more. We have assumed that this solenoid as a thin sheet or thin sheet in a cylindrical form. We need magnetic field at a point P, which is at R distance. There is a center point O, L distance on one side, L distance on another side, total distance 2L of this solenoid. The radius of this solenoid is A. So these are the features. Now let us take a very small piece of this solenoid dx. This is a very small piece in this dark blue color. This is a very small piece. As we have already done, we take very small piece, then we integrate. So this small piece is x distance far. This distance is x. X distance, what is the thickness of this piece? Dx. So we have to calculate, first we will calculate the magnetic field due to this very small piece, very small current carrying loop. So this is a current carrying loop, and then we will calculate the magnetic field due to whole solenoid. First we will calculate for this small area, this small loop, then we will calculate for the whole solenoid. So this is x distance away and thickness is dx. Now important thing is that this dx is very small, so can be neglected. Now what is the distance of P from this loop? So if you see, the total distance is R and this distance is x. So this distance, loop and point is R minus x. The distance between point P and the loop is R minus x. So this is the important distance. This distance between this point and this loop is R minus x. Now let us calculate the axial field of a finite solenoid depicted in this figure. So we will calculate the axial field of this solenoid. Similar, you can remember that we have calculated the magnetic field on the axis due to this current carrying loop. So there was a current carrying loop, and we have calculated the magnetic field due to this current carrying loop on the axis of this circular loop. So now what we will do, so this was for single loop. Suppose if there are number of loops, so what will be done, this magnetic field will be just n times number of loops. This magnetic field will be just n times because there are more number of loops. So similar things we are going to do here. So we are going to measure the axial field of a finite solenoid. So this is the solenoid, we have to measure the axial field. Now we have to assume some of the quantities. Let a finite solenoid, the solenoid shown in this figure, again this solenoid is finite, this is not an infinite solenoid. There are n number of turns per unit length. So this, you know that number of turns per unit length is small n. So capital N is total number of turns. If we divide it by length, what we get? Number of turns per unit length. So let us say total number of turns is n, total length is 2l. So in this way we will get small n, number of turns per unit length. So number of turns per unit length is n, and length of this solenoid is 2l, and radius of this solenoid is a. So this we have already seen, the length is 2l, number of turns per unit length is small n, and radius is a. Now we have to calculate the field at point P. We have to calculate this field at point P. This point P is at R distance. It is at R distance from O. again we can see this point is at r distance from O, center. From center it is at r distance of the solenoid. Now to do this, consider a circular element. So what we have considered, we have considered a very thin element of thickness dx, very small element of the solenoid, and this was d distance from the center. This was x distance from the center dx, and what we need at this point P the magnetic field. This total distance is r. So this distance, remaining distance, is r minus x. Now what would be the number of turns in this small element? This would be simply n into dx, because number of turns per unit length into length. Length is dx, and I is the current in the solenoid. Now we will calculate the magnetic field at point P due to a circular element.